premante. नाम श्रेष्ठं मनुमपि सचि पुत्रमत्र स्वरूपं रूपं तस्यागरयूरपुरीं माथुरीं गोष्ठवाटीं राधाकुण्डं गिरिवरमहोराधिका माधवासं प्राप्तो यस्य प्रथिति कृपया श्रीगुरुं तं नतोऽस्मि वञ्चाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो महावदन्नाय कृष्णप्रेमप्रदाय ते कृष्णाय कृष्णचैतन्यं गौरद्विषे गुरवे गौरचन्द्राय राधिकायै तदालयै कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तद्भक्ताय नमो नमः यं प्रव्रजन्तमनुपेतमपेतकृत्यं द्वैपायनो विरहकातरया जुहा पुत्रेति तन्मयतया तर्वोऽभिनेदो तं सर्वभूतहृदयं मुनिमानतोऽस्मि तवैवास्मि तवैवास्मि न जिमामि त्वया विना इति विज्ञेन राधे तं नयमाम चरणं
Then, about more than 88,000 of Rishis, Maharshis, devotees were assembled in Naimisharanya, and they were questioning to Sūta. There were two Sūta Goswami. There are two Sūtas. One Lomharshan and other is Uccaisava.
Ugrasava.
One was the disciple of Vyas. Lomharshan. When he used to
explain
all the Puran and Itihas, that is Ramayana, Mahabharata and Purans, his heart used to be melted. And that is why lump, this hair,
poor stand up,
used to be standing like Ashtasakti Vikar. But he was killed by whom? Baldev himself. He was so high class of Rishi like and disciple of himself, Vedavyas. But he was killed. He was like a guru. Why he was killed by Baldev Prabhu? When Baldev Prabhu traveling everywhere, when Kauravas or Pandavas were quarreling and big battle of Kurukshetra was going on, and he saw that Krishna wants it and he wants to help
Pandavas,
not to Kauravas. And he thinks that, he always thought that Duryodhana is my disciple. So he left and he began to travel whole India especially to the tirths. To touch the tirths, to make them more powerful. Because he is Baldev. Yeah. So when he reached Naimisharanya, he saw that Sut Goswami, Lomharshan, the disciple of Vyas, very prominent, and he was reading Purans. When he reached there, he could not get up and could not swagat nahi kar saka.
Cannot welcome, offer respect.
If Guru or any higher class of devotees comes, we should try to stand up and to greet him and to do welcome. When he is coming, we should go some thoughts there and then doing pranam, we should welcome him. Give him to seat with seat words and then we can do anything. But he was thinking, I am disciple of Vyas Dev and I am so high class of devotees, all are hearing me. So there was a false ego in him. I am so learned. And he thought that Baldev Prabhu is like householder person. Because at that time he was in Dwarka and he has married Revati and Baruni. So he thought. He has so much honor for Krishna, but not for Baldev. Not thinking, realizing. So he did not stood up. Also, there were so many rishis there, in 88,000 of rishis, so high class of devotees. And he thought that, like disciples, all are hearing me. So sometimes he has that ego that I am more
superior
than them. A kathabachak, a harikatha telling person, sitting on the Vyasasana, he should know all these things, he should know how to respect. So he could not do like this. He thought a common person. So he not welcome and he become furious. Why? Because he is himself Krishna. Especially in the way of Guru. He acts always like Guru. Sometimes punishing, sometimes teaching, sometimes doing all these things. He has plow in his hand. For what thing?
To plow the field.
To give seed in the heart of devotees. First he will plow and make it very fertile, and then he will give bhakti seed. And he has a mota danda.
Club.
Mushal.
Club.
By which? Club nare, godana. Mushal means?
Mushal is a pestle.
Pestle.
And
mortar.
He has kept it. If any wild elephant or any will come, that he will
chase.
Punish. Both things, yeah. Plow is referring to prem. And this, a weapon to
chastise.
Eh?
Chastise.
Both. Guru should be like this. But he was like so. And he cut his head by his, only by doing so. You are not qualified to be a guru. A guru should be realized. Always doing bhajan. And giving proper honor to all the devotees having so much prem in Krishna, like Madhyama Adhikari and he should have so much kripa, mercy to others, beginners, and he should avoid those who are
opposite.
But he was not falling. So he quickly did and he was dead. So if anyone is not doing so, being a guru or Vaishnava, then it's a very big offense. Baldev Prabhu is punishing anyone. So you should try to follow these things. Nowadays I am seeing so many so-called gurus not welcoming, not giving proper respect. What to tell, speak of this? They neglect him, any devotees, and they do opposite. Vridhacharana karte hain.
Opposite.
So, you should try to know all these things and behave them with honor. You should try to learn trina dapi suni chena, taro rapi sahi suna. If there is a guru, but any qualified person more than him comes, at once he should try to
respect him.
If he is doing archan even in the
altar,
in the altar or temple, he must come on and he should respect his guru. Or the Vaishnavas like him are more superior. And if equal rank, he will. I am coming. Like this. And he will tell, oh, you should see, I am waiting. So we should try to follow all these things. So he cut down. We know so many gurus. Here first we will speak about Narada Goswami and Vyas. There are so many kinds of guru. We have heard of the guru Aruni and Uddala. Aruni Upamanna. Aruni was a Brahmin and he was very beautiful and he wanted to read and know all the Vedas, Upanishads, and he came to his Gurudev. He told that you should be at least 12 years being brahmacharya and serving here. And he was serving. One day, the wife of his guru, he himself told that today is rainy day, very cold days, and so much rain. You should at once go to the field and repair
the dikes.
So that water should not go away, otherwise paddy will not be given. He went in the night, and whole night he was repairing, but he could not do. He was giving mud, so much mud, but as the current was so
strong
that it used to take away. Then he slept there. By his body he was checking, stopping the water. And water is so cold, raining, that he became like wood. Only some sense was there in the meantime. Gurudev came searching him, "Oh Aruni, where you are, where you are?" He told, "Guruji, I am here." "Oh, what are you doing here?" "I'm lying down to check, to stop water." "Oh." Then he went there and saw that he's about to die. He touched him and he became very energetic again, and he took him and told, giving his hands on his head, "Oh, all Ved, all Upanishad with meaning should come in your heart." And quickly everything was there. So Guru should be like that, and Shishya should be like that. Nowadays, so many students, so many disciples with Gurudev, and when he will order him anything very hard,
difficult
for them, they will at once give up the ashram and quickly run away. They want that, "Oh Gurudev, why you made me guru, me disciple, if you cannot offer me, or you cannot give me,
supply
me my food, my clothing, logic, my faring to go to India and coming to India and here and there. You should, if you are not paying that, I am going to a very special Gurudev who can pay all these things and nourish and support me. Why you did?" So you should not be like that. Also there is a Guru, Upamanyu, know. He went to his Gurudev, that Gurudev, "I want to read Vedas Upanishad and I want to know the real truths. Oh, you should be also 12 years for in my this, and you will have to graze my cows." He went to graze cows, nothing, ABCD of Upanishad, nothing doing. 12 years you should go on like that. In the meantime, you can fly away, no harm. But when you have faith in 12 years to me, then quickly I will do all these things. In the meantime, he was going grazing cows. He saw that one day, he asked the boy, "Upamanyu, you are so energetic and you are so healthy, what you are taking?" He told that when all the calves are satisfied with the milk of their mothers, then remaining something I take, and thus I am okay. "Oh, I have not told you to do so. Don't do like this. Otherwise you are thief. Correct yourself." Then he left this and going on. After some months he saw that he is still so strong. He asked that, "Now what you are doing? How you are maintaining your life?" "Oh, when the calves taking their mother's milk and they sit down, cows, and when they are doing
chewing,
some
foam
comes, and I used to take from, and I take." "Oh, don't do. I have not told you to do. Go on grazing, but don't do this." Then he was so hungry. One day he was thinking what to do. He saw that there are some leaves very fat,
thick,
having so
very
thick and having some like milk if they are broken. And it is called
Akava
in India, in Sanskrit Asava. But it is so poisonous that if if any
drop
or anything will come in eyes,
I'll go away.
They will at once go away. So he was taking this because he was so
hungry
to maintain his life. Not telling Gurudev, "You should give me something, otherwise I will give up you." He has not initiated still. He was looking and testing. And thus he was grazing the cows, but his eyes were not, and he fell down in a well. It became evening, and it was going to be night. cows were in the shade of Rishis, his master. And he saw that, oh, today Upamanyu has not reached even where he is, cows has come. And he was searching, Upamanyu, who are, where you are. And from a while he told, Guruji, I am here. What are you doing in the well? Oh, I fell down. Why you fell down? I took Ekvan, and thus it came in my eyes. I became blind, so I could not return. Oh, and he went there and he took him out of the well and told, what I have obeyed, how I have told to you, you have obeyed me and serving me. Now you are
qualified.
And he gave his hand and told that all Brahma Vidyas and all Vedic knowledge should come in you. And at once it came. Also, Rup Goswami, Jiva Goswami. Jiva Goswami was
disciple
of Rup Goswami. Also, there are so many, like Raghunath, disciple of Swarup Damodar, Shiksha Guru. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gave him his hand. How he was serving his Gurudev. He was not telling Gurudev, you should
supply
me Jagannath Prasadam, Luchi Puri, Halwa, Mahan Bhog, and all these things. So tasteful sweets, never. Day and night chanting, remembering and serving. What Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was Swarup Damodar told. And very soon, he began to weep always. Ashtasattvik Vikar. I think that this disciple is more superior than Upamanyu and Aruni. Then he knew Vedas, Vedic knowledge. But the essence of Ved is Srimad Bhagavatam, or rasa, or bhakti. And among bhakti, gopi bhakti is more superior. Raghunath was serving Hari Gurudev, annotating this thing. But how? Left everything, his home, like kingdom, beautiful wife like angels, more than angels. And so rich person left his everything and became Ganeshakau.
Tattva
turnam ashesh mandal patim shading sada tukshvat bhutva dina Ganeshakau karunaya kofin ganthashitav. They left all Rup Sanatan, Raghunath Das Goswami. Mandal patim shreni. What is mandal shreni? Vaibhav, appellants like so much emperor. Wives, children, father, mother, everything for Krishna consciousness. And became Dina Ganeshakau. Dina Ganeshakau.
Meek and humble.
Very humble and very akincha, having nothing. Dina Ganeshakau,
Karunaya
Kopin Kanthasitau. And only door and Kopin was there. Nothing. And thus, doing all the chanting, remembering. In the ocean of rush, of sweet pastimes of Krishna all doing. So we should try to be like that, Rupa Raghunath and all others, if you want to have prem like this. Without serving Gurudev, we cannot be like this. Don't try to cheat Gurudev. But Gurudev should be also so qualified, not so called Guru, and Shish also not so called disciple. No harm you are living in family life. No harm. You can develop your Krishna. So here, first of all, Sut Goswami is telling, first he told, Shabai punsang paro dharmo jato bhakti radhokshaje ahe tukya pratihata jyatma samprasidati. He has asked, punsam ekantata shreyas tanno sansutam arhasi bruhi na saddhananan jenatma samprasidati. All the rishis were asking Sut Goswami, you know all the Vedas, Upanishads, all the Puran, Itihas. You are disciple of Vyasadeva. So you should try to give essence of all, how we, all the jivas, especially in Kali Yuga. Shreya, Shreya means?
Benefited.
Benefited. How? Now, Kali Kal is very, very dangerous, very dangerous. Perhaps you are realizing these are not, I am not thinking. But those he will realize quickly, they will be what?
Detached.
Detached with them. And those who are not realizing this, oh, I will give up all these things tomorrow. After tomorrow, after 1 year, when my wife will die, or when my husband will die, when I will be old, never you will be old. In the meantime, if you die, then what?
What will happen, Guru Bhai?
So, at once do what you want to do, just now. So he is telling that you should tell me how we can be what?
Benefited.
Benefited in this life, so that our life will be successful. And then he is telling, Shabai punsan, paro dharmo jato bhakti radhokkaje ahetukya vyavahita jatma samprasiddhati. Only there is only way. What that is? Bhakti. To whom? To whom? Purushottame. Who is Purushottam? Krishnastu Bhagavan Swayam. So bhakti in the lotus feet of Krishna. But it should be ahetuki.
Causeless.
And spontaneous. And by this, Atma will be pleased, happy. What Atma? There are two kinds of Atma. One Atma, Paramatma, and another is his
Jivatma.
His
part and parcel.
Part and parcel. That is Atma. So if Krishna is pleased, then our Atma will be pleased. And if you are not pleasing him, by this bhakti, continuous and without any reason, then vadanti tattva vidastattam yajgyam advayam brahmeti parmatmeti bhagavaniti shabdade. He told that vadanti tattva vidas, those who are qualified in tattva, established truths, they told that advaya jnana is paramatattva. Who is advaya jnana? Krishna is himself advaya jnana. How? How he is Advaita? There is no second to Krishna, no another Bhagavan. Shankara and all others are not Bhagavan. Brahma is not Bhagavan. They are part and parcels of Krishna. So only Krishna is Advaita Jnana Paratattva. But how we are seeing so many persons and so many worlds and so many things? Oh, it has come by his own power. That is Swarup Shakti. Swarup Shakti becomes or works like three ways. Swarup Shakti, Bhairanga Shakti, and
Jiva
Shakti. From Jiva Shakti we have come so many. And from Swarup Shakti, all Vaikunths and all others there. And by Maya Shakti, all has come. So, only from Krishna, all these arts. So, all including is Bhagavan. So, if you are doing bhakti to him, your life will be successful, otherwise not. So, Śrīmantāṁ svakathā Krishna punya śravana kirtana hridyantasto hiya bhadrāṇi vidhuno sohit sadam. If you will hear the powerful and very sweet harikatha, pastimes of Krishna, only by hearing and hearing, nothing to practice. Parikshit Maharaj never practiced anything because after 7 days he paused. He went on. So he, only by hearing, what? Krishna will come by throw his these ears here. And he will clear all these things and make a seat forever here. And after that, vidhunot, nashta prayeshu abhadreshu. If there is any anartha there, he will clear all the anarths. And then, nityam bhagavat sevaya, sadhana bhakti, here sadhana bhakti. Then will come bhava bhakti. And then, bhava bhakti will come, then bhakti will be nashtiki. Nashtiki means not coming lower down. Staying in and gradually
increase.
Vidyate hridaya granthi. Chindante sarva samsaya chyante chasya karmani dishta evatma nishvare. If anyone will hear, see Krishna here, vidyate hridaya granthi. Hridaya granthi means the knot of jiva and maya. There is a knot. If you are trying yourself by your intelligence and senses, it will more
tightly
tighten. Like elephants in daldal.
Mud.
Quicksand.
Quicksand. If elephants are trying, going down, down, down. And if they will give up everything and lie down, anyone can come and take them out. So we should be like that. Surrender ourselves. And praying Krishna. Then all doubts will go away. Chyante chasya karmani. And what he has done in past life, so many karmas, its fruits will be burnt. Good and bad, everything. And then the kavis have. Ato vai kaviyo nityam bhakti param maya muda vasudeve bhagavati kurvanti atma prasidanam. So all the intelligent Vaishnavas, devotees, so try to develop their Krishna consciousness in this human life very quickly. Other we can be die. If death comes, we cannot do anything. So as soon as possible, we should try to. And telling this, he began to tell that once Vyasadeva, Dwapare, when Dwapar came, and it was going to be end in the last time of
Dwapar Yuga.
Dwapar Yuga.
The end.
Shaunu prapte tritiye yuga parjaye jata parashara dyogi. Then from Parashara Vyasadeva came. And at that time he had done Vedas, who came from Krishna himself by his nose. Nose of Karanabdhisai Vishnu. Vedas come. Not really from Krishna. From Karanabdhisai Vishnu. Vedas are coming. And it were, all were revealed in the heart of Brahma. But up to Dwapar, all became having no brahmacharya. Not so much pure ghee, doodh, and all other things. No pure air, no pure water. Nowadays in Ganges, in Jamuna, anyone cannot drink water because so impure. Also, no good air, fresh air, which are essential for life. No brahmacharya.
Celibacy.
Even brahmacharis and sannyasis, it is very hard for them to maintain brahmacharya. So they lost their memory. They have to invent something. Then paper and pen to write. What is your name? My name is Urdhramanthi. What? Then they will have some machine here.
Like
what you told? Urdhvamanthi. Then what again? Urdhva. How to write?
Write it. It's true.
Then we discovered
black box.
These black things. To remember. But by the help, taking help, we lost our memory more. Because we'll have to depend on them. Up till our time, serving Gurudev, all these coverings were not there. And we used to take all in this. So you can think that being an old, I myself, remembering so much thousands and thousands of slokes and so many things, at once replying so many things, you can. I have no help of
black box.
Never. So best thought, nowadays Kali is coming, now remembrance is going on. Dan, Satya, Tapa, humility, all the qualities are going on. And now all are becoming bhogi. So he divided Vedas in four. Rig, Sam, Jajur, Atharva. And he made his disciples Rigved, Pailam, Sam, Jaimini, Atharvaved, Jajurved, Vaishampayan, Atharvaved, Sumanta. And Itihas, like Mahabharatam, and all the Puran, he taught to Deshrut, Lomaharsha, who was killed by Baladev.
So, this
is going on with Lomaharsha? No, and that time Baladev Prabhu cut the head of that, and then all rishis were weeping. What you have done? From where we will hear all Purans? And then he told the yes, I'm managing. And his son, very
5 years,
little, only 5 years,
naked
there. And he took that boy and he gave his hands. Everything, more than your father, all Vedas, Upanishads, Itihas, Puran, everything should come out in your mind. And he at once remembered all things. And he told that you should sit and you should
speak.
From 5 years, age, he began to recite all these things. So a guru should be like Baladev Prabhu. So here, he did all these things. He also made Mahabharata for ladies who are not, they cannot be always pure. Sometimes in a month or they should have to be impure. And they cannot remember all the Upanishad, all these things. Very hard for them. Because they are very soft-hearted, very sweet. So for them and all others, those who are out of Varnashram Dharma, for them, he made Mahabharata. And in Mahabharata, he made a very Upanishad, like Gita Upanishad. After that, he saw that. In Vedas and Upanishads, there are so many things, though mantra, who are opposite to each other. And general person cannot reconcile all. Sometimes he has written, apanipado javana grihita pasatta chakchuk srinottya karana. Like this, that God, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, has no hands, he has no feet, nothing, no eyes, but he does all. And sometimes he has written that Anandamayam Brahma, Brahma is Ananda. And sometimes he has told that Nirgun, Brahma is Nirgun. Sometimes Nirgun. Sometimes he has told that Supreme Personality of God has some shape, some qualities. He is merciful. He has so and so. And sometimes he is telling Satyam, Jnanam, Anantam, Brahma. Only qualities are there. No shape, no attribute, nothing. Sometimes he is telling Parashakti Vividhaiva Sruyate. And sometimes he is telling that opposite thing, that there are no attribute, no power, nothing. He is Aja, like this. How to reconcile all these things? He was bound to make Brahma Sutra. No? Then, kato no?
45
minutes. Then he made Brahma Sutra. First Brahma Sutra is Athato Brahma Jigyasa. What is Brahma? There were different ideas in Vedas and Upanishad. He wanted to reconcile all and to make a very good sutra. Sutra means?
Condensed form.
Condensed form. Janamadash Jata. This is the word. From whom all the world comes. Who supports all. And after, in the end, all enters in them. Jato vaimani bhutani jayante jena jatani yad jivanti yad abhishanti tad vijyasa tad brahma. Who supports, who makes, and who he is Brahma. And sometimes satyam, jnanam, jnani is only Brahma. Then how to reconcile? So he made all these things. Shastra Yoni Dvat. He is the Yoni of Shastra. He is the root cause of all the Shastra. Our Shastra always define him. So many things. Anandamayo, not Ananda only. He is Ananda and Anandamaya both. Both at a time. How? For this he made Purans. And especially Srimad Bhagavatam. But up till now he had not done. He was thinking that artha, dharma, kama, moksha, everything I have done, but I'm not satisfied. Why I'm not satisfied? I'm not happy. Something lacking. What is lacking? He was thinking. And in the meantime, a Mahatma came. Who was he? He was Narada. Narada Rishi Bhajaya Veena
Radhika
Ramana Nami. With his Veena he came. And he was singing Radhe Jaya Jaya
Mahapadame.
Can you do?
Radhe Jaya Jaya.
Making so late. At once. Tungi and all you can do? Oh, they will not do. Go on, go on.
Radhe Jaya Jaya Mahadabhadai Radhe Jaya.
singing like so. Also, after this, Radhe Jaya Jaya.
Radha Raman.
No. Jaya Radha Madhava.
Jaya.
Not singing, then those who are singing, their sins, their unearths, their offenses, all will
come out,
and
move,
they will fly in air.
And
those who are not singing, they will
enter
in there. So you should all do like
this.
The bank of a river named Saraswati. But he could not imagine what is fault in me, what is lacking in me, And he was so worried for this. In the meantime, Narad Rishi doing kirtan, and he came at once. Vyas saw him, and at once he stood up, and he honored in so many ways. He washed the feet of Narad Goswami and gave a very beautiful seat of Kushasan. Not like this, Kushasan. And gave water to drink and for everything. And when he was satisfied, then Narada at once told, "Oh, you are a guru. You have divided Vedas. You had made Brahma Sutra. You have done so many Purans. You have done Mahabharata. And everything you have done. You have taught all the person, human, for human being, how they can be happy. And so you have done all these things. But I am saying that you are unhappy. Why you are unhappy?" Then he replied, "Gurudev, I don't know why I am unhappy. You are a Vishal,
doctor.
Like a
Ayurvedic doctor.
You can see why I am unhappy. I have done everything. And all human being has made me guru. But still I am not satisfied. I have reconciled all the Vedas mantra, Upanishad. It is very hard to know all these things. And to know the essence of Vedas, it is too hard for any human being. For also for any very learned person, they will be bewildered in that. But you have done. I have done. What you are telling, I have done all things. But still, I am lacking something. You know that Vyasa is Sakshat Narayan. He is Saktavesh Avatar, incarnation. But still he is unhappy. Without Guru. If anyone is not initiating, not associating, not following his Gurudev totally, and if there is anything is lacking here, not telling to his Gurudev, he cannot be successful. So Vyasadeva is telling, "Oh, I have opened my heart to you, and you should see what is lacking." Then he told, he began to smile. He began to smile and told that, "Oh, something is lacking. What you have done for artha dharma kama, yatha dharma adyas chartha, muni varjyan kirtita. You have done so much to attain dharma, artha, artha mane money, kama, and that is desires, and
moksha.
You have tried so much for these things, but you have not tried to glorify Krishna, Supreme Personality of Godhead. You have confused in your writings whether he has shape or not. You have not glorifying him by his so sweet and powerful
pastimes.
Have you told anywhere that Krishna is the son of Yashoda and Nanda Baba coming from the womb? You have told that he is transcendental. He is Aja. But you have not told like this. Have you told that Yashoda Ma had tightened in his grundle motor? Never. Have you? You have told anywhere that Yashoda took the ear of Krishna and he twisted it and Krishna became fearful and he was weeping so much loudly, oh mother, I will not do again like this." Have you written all this? Never, I have not written. Have you written that gopis are toyed in Rash Leela and ordering Krishna that bring our ankles right? Ankle bells. Right? And you can massage our feet. And Krishna is taking the feet, dust of gopis, mother, Nanda Baba, Yashoda. He is taking, carrying the shoes of
Nanda Baba.
Have you written? Never have. Then what you have written? He is ocean of rush. Rasho Vaishaha. Sahiya rush. Oh, I have not known all these things. Oh, then go. And at once, quickly, be pure and be in trance, praying Krishna that his all pastimes should come in your heart. I'm telling my own experience that I was Manasputra Brahma, but anyhow I became, come to this world and became son of any?
Maid servant.
Low class. When I was of 5 years, some rishis like Sanak Sanandan, Sanat Kumar and all realized rishis came in my village and they wanted to be there for 4 months in rainy season. So they made some huts there and they used to tell Hari Katha and worshipping Krishna and telling Hari Katha so much each other. My mother was engaged there as a maid servant to wash the pots, to wash, clean the
area
and everything. I used to go with them. One day, I requested them to give their remnants. And it was
attached to leaf
in
plate.
Any leaf.
Leaf plate.
So they quickly get me. And sometimes they used to keep for me something.
Knowingly.
And they gave. The power of feet water. And remnants and padadhuli.
Dust
of these Vaishnavas are so powerful to clean the heart. And
remnant of
for bhakti giving, for powerful. Krishna Das Kaviraj Ji Swami has told what?
Bhakta Pada Dhuliyar. Announcing.
With the sounds of any drum. Oh, hear me.
Declared.
The feet water of any Vaishnava. The Vaishnava Pada Dhuli. Dhuli means the?
Feet dust.
And remnant. Remnants of two kinds. First remnant, any prasadam. And more prasadam is his words.
Harikatha.
If anyone serving this thing, oh, so he will be purified and he will achieve Krishna prema very soon. So, by taking this, in 5 days I become so pure. I have a transcendental faith in my heart that by serving Krishna, our life will be successful. And when they were going, I began to weep. They gave also some mantra. I was thinking that what I will do after they are going. So I am so worried and weeping. They went on and my mother was taking me in, always in lap. I have no time to chant that mantra. So I thinking, what should I do? Oh, Krishna, arrange. At once, one day, my mother was going to milk cow in very evening in some darkness and a snake, poisonous snake, bite and she at once died. And he quickly saw that his, my mother is dead, at once quickly run away in forest and went in dense forest where wild beasts like lion, tigers and mad elephants used to be there. But no fear at all. Only fear from Kali, all these things. Material attachment. So he quickly ran out there and he took bath in a very pure pond and sat down and began to
meditate
that mantra. Very quickly, in some ways, this, and he saw a trance, in his trance saw
lightning.
Narayan, Shankh Chakra Gadadhara. And at once it quickly vanished. Then I began to weep so loudly. I wanted to die. Diving in the river any, or jumping from any mountain. But at once,
an aerial sound
came.
A voice from the sky.
From Ken. Oh, don't die, don't die, don't be. Anyone cannot see me if this karma-krita body, this body made by karma. Now you cannot see me. Go on chanting and remembering, touring in whole world, my names. And thus a time will come where all karmas will go away. And then death will come and you can keep your feet on the head of that death, and quickly giving up this body, you will have a transcendental body. And by that you can go anywhere in any sphere in Vaikunth, Vrindavan, in this world. So, I have some experience. So now you should go and be in trance, praying Krishna, adopting bhakti. Then he went and bhakti yogena manasi samyak panimite amasyat purusham purnam mayancha dada pashaya. जया सम्मोहितो जीव आत्मानं त्रिगुणात्मकं परोपि मनुते अनर्थं तत्कृतं चाभिपपद्यते अनर्थोपशमं साक्षात् भक्तियोगमध्योक्षिजे लोकस्य अजानतो विद्वान् चक्रे सांहितायां यस्य वै श्रूयमाणायं कृष्णे परमपुरुषे भक्ति उपपद्यते पुंसः शोकमोह. Then he, in trance, you see, in trance means he surrendered himself, unconditionally surrendered. Oh Krishna, I am yours. Be merciful to me. Sprinkle your mercy. I want to see you and I want to show your all pastimes that Narada has shown. And quickly he realized, apashyata purusham purna. Purna Purush, Purna, Purnam Buddham, Purnat Purnam Udhuchyate, Purnasya Purnam Adaya Purnam Evasishya. Krishna is not zero. His shape is there. His all the attributes are there. Parashakti Vividhaiva Shruyate. In Parakrishna, all the Parashaktis are there, indifferent to Krishna. And by this, he can do parinam, in parinam, all Vaikunth Loks, Vrindavan Dham, Golok Dham, all these worlds, lakhs and lakhs he can do. He saw all from beginning coming in the womb of
Mother Yashoda,
and he saw also that at the same time, in the same night, at the same 12
Midnight.
He saw that he also came
manifested
in the Kansa jail, in front of Devaki and Yashoda, and in Vasudeva. And at the same time, he saw that from coming Krishna from the womb of Yashoda, and also a girl came out that was Jogmaya. And thus, from beginning to end, Dwarka Lila, everything he saw in his hands, everything. And then he revealed it as a Srimad Bhagavatam. So Bhagavat, he saw. Bhagavat is not new that he wrote. Bhagavat is not a paper and ink. nothing. Transcendental knowledge, transcendental past of Krishna, which Brahma realized here and again Vyasis. And then he wrote it for them. Jasa vai suyamanayam krishne paramahurshe bhakti rupat upapadyate punsav shok moha bhayava. And he wrote for all these worldly persons that reading all these things, he will be perfect and he will thus go away for shok moha and bhayamans.
Illusion. Lamentation, illusion, fear.
And kasht prema bhakti will come. So first thing is that our all disciplic acharyas have propagated the message of bhakti. Bhaktya aham ekaya grahya. In bhakti, there should be Bhagavan, there should be Bhakta, and there should be Bhakti. There should be Aradhana, Aradha and Aradhak. So, Bhakti is like a person, Parashakti Para, Ladini and Sambhid. The essence of both is Bhakti. In word, another word we can tell that Srimati Radhika is Vidyavadhu. Know her. So we should first obey our Gurudev. Gurudev should be also qualified. We should be very far away from monism, Advait Bhad. We should not consider that we are same as Brahma, we are Brahma. Never. And if you have this idea in any way, bhakti will never come in you. So Vyasdev himself has told, Diyamane nam grhananti bina matsevaram jana. If Krishna is giving himself this Shaiji Mukti or anything, any devotee will not take. Bina matsevam, bina, without bhakti. Only they will take bhakti. Everywhere in Srimad Bhagavat and Gita, Vedanta, Upanishad, everywhere it has been told that Krishna has shape, beautiful shape. All shapes have come out from him. He cannot be shapeless. He cannot be powerless. Never. And we cannot be Brahma. Never we cannot be Brahma. We can be servant, eternal servant of Krishna. So you should obey your Prabhupada also. We should try to obey Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur, our Gurudev. They were quite opposite to this monism. If anything, anyone is doing association of that persons who have some monism, that we are Brahma, they are making offense in the lotus feet of their Gurudev, Swamiji, and also all Guru like Prabhupada. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and all. I request that if you have any association from your friends, try to give up like a stool. It will be benefit for you. Don't take association of any devotee who is life even. We should give up all these things for Krishna. Krishna will see and he will sprinkle his mercy to them. Now there are so many, they are thinking that we are Ritvika, Nastik-like, and thinking that I am Brahma. Jiva Goswami has told that we are abhinna from Krishna. These ideas are just opposite to bhakti. We should try to cancel all these things and try to have bhakti in Guru first. Jasya devi parabhakti yatha devi tatha guru tasyaite kattahi artha prakashante mahat. So we should try to obey fully our spiritual master totally and then offer ourselves in the lotus feet of Krishna. Krishna having transcendental body, transcendental all qualities, so merciful, so beautiful, so jolly, having all quality in this world. So we should not think that he is nirakar, nirvishesh, brahma, or we are equal to him or like him. So give up these all these things and try to be follow Srila Vyasadeva, Srila Narada Goswami, Brahma, Rupa Goswami, Sanatana Goswami, Mahaprabhu and all his associates. Then we can learn something. First this is thing, to obey our Gurudev. If anyone not obeying our Gurudev, his Gurudev, that he should be given up at once. Gaur Pramanand
Hare Hare.
Any like this?
We have a certain Australian too.
Then you can do?
Australian too.
Anandi? Anandini? You should begin, begin, begin.
No, 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 no. They're going to do. They're going to do. In the back.
No butter, no ghee.
Mm-hmm.